Welcome back, and we are still shooting from the very special and unique place, Sultan Hassan Mosque and Madrasa. This mosque consists of schools for all the Sunni schools of Shafi'i, Maliki, Hanafi, and Al-Hanbali. The mosque is considered one of the largest in the world. It's measuring 150 meters in length and covering the area of 7.96 square meter. This mosque is very important for its historical importance. And to know more about the history of this mosque, we are joined by Mr. Yasser Hamdi, and he's a monument inspector. Hello, sir, and welcome to Ashraf.
Hello.
Mr. Yasser, thank you very much for being with us today on Nile Cruise. If we can speak about the importance and the significance of Sultan Hassan Mosque, why was it built? Was it only for praying, or did it have other purposes, as Dina said?
When we talk about the construction, better to say school, not a mosque.
Yes.
What school I mean this madrasa was built for children to study in, where to study for sect. When we look to it, is construction, we can see this like open court in the middle with four arches. Where the four arches dedicated for four sects, where we know in Islam for Muslim or for a Sunni, we have four sects, one of them called Hanbali, Maliki, Hanafi, Shafi'i. So this place or this building was built to teach. That's where the main arch or main Iwan. Iwan is where this meaning empty space with the arch in the beginning. The main one where Qibla or direction of Mecca, the niche where the Muslim face when they want to pray was built anywhere we call the main one where this construction in. This dedicated for Hanbali sect where this was the main sect in this time. But sometimes some people call this a mosque, no, not a mosque, where in this building also we can find the student cells for the students to study and to live in. As well as to a hospital, especially this hospital for eyes, where you know in Middle Ages children face a lot of troubles with the eyes. Why? Because they used the ink to write. So there was a doctor here for eyes, and also in this building we can find the remains of water wheels, where the water was from underground in here. And also the students living here. Who lived in from the students? The students are completely the madrasa or the school dedicated for the children where no parents for them, where the parents were died in this time, where the main role for the government or for Sultan Hassan, he built this construction to find the place for the children to study in here in the school.
Okay, tell us more about Sultan Hassan and the purpose of building. You said it's schools for teaching Quran and Islam and the Sunni. It has a madrasa for the four Sunni sects. So tell us more about the history of this place and the man who built it.
For the space before Sultan Hassan to build his madrasa here, this was in same place there was built a palace. But he destroyed this palace and he built the madrasa or the school here, madrasa, in two important places. Where this place or this square called Saladin Square or Midan Salahuddin. Saladin Square, this is the most important square in Islamic Cairo. Why? Because when we look around, we can see a lot of construction, not only Sultan Hassan School. In other side, we can see Mosque of Rifa'i. And in other side also we can see Mahmoudiya or Madrasat al-Mahmoudiya or Mahmoudiya School, as well as in front of us we can see Muhammad Ali Mosque in the citadel. What this mean? Meaning when we look to the construction here, we not find only Madrasa or Sultan Hassan Madrasa, where this meaning Mamluk School, but we find also Ottoman Madrasa, Mahmoudiya, and also Muhammad Ali Mosque, where this one date back to Muhammad Ali Dynasty, as well as Rifa'i Mosque, where this one date back to Muhammad Ali Dynasty, where was built by Khushyar Hanim, mother of Khedev Ismail. Sultan Hassan School, the most important mosque here in the most important madrasa or building in the location, because this is a great construction. When we look to its construction, we can see this is the biggest one in Islamic construction in this time. maybe not in this time still, or to this time where we are now, where Sultan Hassan, when he started to build the construction, he spent a lot of money to build this one. And once they want to stop, he not wanted to complete the construction, but he said, a shame for a king of Egypt to stop to build the construction he was started to do. So when we look also to the madrasa, we can see the biggest dome in this one in its time. And also we can see very nice minarets where we have a high minarets in Cairo in this madrasa. And also there was in the plan here, he would be wanted to build four minarets around the mosque where he built two of them in east direction. And there was a plan to build two minarets in top of the main entrance where are next to us here. But one of them was destroyed during the construction directly. And when this one destroyed, where we have a famous story for this one, where killed about 300 kids were died from the children here. So he refused to rebuild this minaret and another minaret. When we look also for the construction, we can see they used a limestone in biggest Islamic construction, where I told you if we have in ancient time the Great Pyramid in Giza, for the ancient Egyptian history, we have Sultan or Madrasat Sultan Hassan or Sultan Hassan School. We call this pyramid of the Islamic history.
So it took a lot of money to be constructing this mosque, Sultan Hassan Mosque, for different purposes. Where does the mosque rank around the world in terms of size, as terms of a mosque? Is it the biggest in the world?
This one were biggest in the world in the construction, but in Middle Ages, where you know now a lot of modern mosques were built around the world. No, I think we have a famous mosque in Emirates where this too big, and another one in Morocco also big. But in any way, we here we not can link between this one and the mosques around or in Egypt or in other countries, because we look for this one a madrasa, not a mosque. So this where this a big difference between the two construction, but in its time was the biggest madrasa around the Islamic world.
When President Obama came here to Egypt, he insisted to visit this place. So why?
When we look to this this issue where we have a political side and religious side in this time, Mr. Obama or president or American president in this time when he came to visit Egypt, he talk about his open hand for Islamic world to do a peace with Islamic world, and he wanted to come from here to see the Islamic culture, where also I think the Egyptian government in this time wanted to show for him our great history, where the Islamic history, a great history, not only for what they wrote in books, is also for the construction. So this was a good place to see the construction and the great construction for its arches, where we know in Iraq there was a big arch called Iwan Kisra. Iwan Kisra was too big arch, too big construction, but this one biggest than this one. So for this reason, I think they wanted to show for him the Islamic culture and what the Islam mean, what is also the Islamic role for the local society, where I told you this madrasa where meaning school, so the Islam always take care for the kids, especially where I told you no parents for them. So many, many messages they want to send for him, and also on other side to see this location and a lot of important building around in Islamic Cairo.
So Sultan Hassan was looked upon or seen as a madrasa or a school for the children. What about the wonders of its construction?
What about
the wonders of its construction, the way it was
generally
built?
Generally, where you remember before when I said we have here a big dome, a big or high minaret, and also look to the construction where you can see the walls too high. And also I talk to you about the arch inside where I said this bigger than Iwan Kisra, and the Iwan Kisra in its time was too important arch in the history. So when you look to this one, you find this one not too important for many reasons in madrasa, not only for the construction, also for the history, also for everything around.
Well, Mr. Yasir Hamdi, we are moving now to a quick break and coming back, so please stay tuned.